Well, I also have my colleague Suesha joining us on this live broadcast. Suesha, certainly a historic day. And, 2020 has been a difficult year. 2021 certainly coming with good news. We're starting with our vaccination process soon enough, as being said by a lot of experts. And like pointed out by the AIIMS director as well, what's important right now, of course, apart from the administrative challenges, is that people step forward, they get themselves vaccinated. There is a good amount of awareness that is created around the vaccination drive.
In fact, he puts a lot of things into perspective, Ritsveen, in terms of... He clarifies on what the bigger aim is, and that is to reduce the mortality rate. So primarily, it is to focus on the fact that 2020, obviously, the struggle has been very big. Now that 2021 has begun, and we have more clarity and a nod on both these vaccines, the idea is to reduce the mortality rate. Of course, he's said that more data will be needed, and he's also said that a strong immunization plan is ready. Plus, taking care of the eventualities, he's saying that it is important to be proactive rather than being caught off guard. We continue to put out all the live reactions that have been coming in so far, as the AIIMS director also says that it is important to trust our scientists and our doctors who have been working very hard to find a solution, a vaccine to COVID.
So it is a matter of great relief and a pivotal point that we have emergent regulatory approvals for two of the vaccines. Now, one of the things takes a lot of effort for IT solutions, planning, logistics, storage, cold chain, train the trainer programs. On top of all this, it also needs a coordinated care among various healthcare groups, regulatory authorities, government officials to ensure the first phase of vaccination is going to be done. The first phase will probably cover 3% of the population, as what we know from the government sources, which would include the healthcare, all sections of the healthcare workers, including doctors, nurses, hospital porters, cleaning system, everyone included in that, plus uniformed services at the state level and the town municipal corporation employees, whoever are frontline workers, should all be included, encompassed within this 3% of the population or 3 crore. Once this is done, again we would have robust data, and that data will help plan the phase 2, which will be population that is at-risk population, which is mainly people over 60 with comorbidities. And then we will also have the phase 4 or the post-marketing survey data rolling in by then. Later on, we also hope that the vaccine will be available in the market commercially for prescription and use. And at that time, electively, people can also get vaccinated. Developing a herd immunity due to vaccination is the ideal and preferred way. There are going to be stray incidents of adverse reports or serious adverse reports, and that is so true with any vaccination. More so, there will be also a lot of rumors, given that in the current era, there is so much of a social media glare and circulation availability. Therefore, our earnest appeal is there have been dry runs. Most secure vaccines like the AstraZeneca, that is the Serum Institute, Covishield and Covaxin, are going to be rolled out. Well, these are ideal vaccines, 2 to 8 degree centigrade, and with that kind of a temperature requirement, the logistics will become easier. Now, we're not readily in the cusp of getting Pfizer or Moderna, and the logistics there will be different. number of side effects are being seen with the mRNA vaccines like Pfizer or Moderna. Fortunately, AstraZeneca has not had a major serious adverse event, and there will be number of reactions which are probably may happen in vaccinator group but unrelated to vaccine. So we are excited and we look forward to the both the vaccines and the phase one of the vaccination drive. The most important aspect is once you get vaccinated, do not dispense with the mask. Mask is here to stay for the next 2 years. Physical distancing and all the commandments of keeping COVID away will depend upon precautions plus vaccination. Thank you.